Good morning to WOW, Word on Wednesday, as we continue our journey through Lent. For many of us, we've been following that series, Stones in the Wilderness. And if you remember last week, we were speaking about the power of words. In the process, we're encouraged to look at one word a day and to reflect on that, meditate upon it, also to come up with our own word, and then also to allow that to form part of our devotions and our praying. And so we need to allow our imagination to run wild, to get active, and to think about different things as we respond to God in our prayers and our meditations. This past week, someone shared on our Bible study chat group a joke which got me thinking. And the joke goes like this. It's about a little boy who was afraid of the dark. And one night, his mother told him to go out onto the back porch and to please bring in her broom. Little boy turned to his mother and said, "Mom, I don't want to go out there. It's dark." To which his mother smiled reassuredly and explained, "You don't have to be afraid about the dark or afraid of the dark, my son. Jesus is out there. He will look after you and he will protect you." The little boy looked deep and hard at his mother and asked, "Are you absolutely sure that he is there?" "Yes, I'm absolutely sure. He's everywhere. He's always ready to help when we need him." The little boy thought about that for a while and then tentatively went to the kitchen, opened the back door just a crack, and peering out into the darkness, he called out, "Jesus, if you're out there, please will you hand me the broom?" Well, we can explain the joke in a number of different ways. We talk about it as being lateral thinking, but a lot depends on how we view a situation is about our experience, our understanding of the words that are spoken or the way that the words come to us. But inevitably, we, many of us, think differently about the same situation. When people view things differently, sometimes they're amazed at the way that other people view the same situation. And we come up with a phrase that helps us to explain that. We say that those people are thinking out of the box. And if it's really different from us, then we think they're way out of the box. But people view things differently. As we were working through our meditations this past week of Stones in the Wilderness, that phrase came to mind. Think out of the box. I know it's a bit of a cliche about the way we think of things, but as I reflect on the Bible and characters within the Bible, we see that many of them struggled with the way that God was working or the way that God acted. And we see this with Jesus, we see it with Moses, we see it with the disciples. Moses, when he's challenged at the burning bush to lead the people out of Egypt, it must have been quite daunting for him. But as he goes to lead the people out of Egypt, there's very little that happens in that whole journey that fitted into their frame of thinking. Most of what happened was out-of-the-box thinking for them. The disciples, as they interact and journey with Jesus, just about every miracle that Jesus performed for them was out of the box. You just think of how do we feed 5,000 people with a few loaves of bread and a couple of fish? That was really thinking out the box. What about when the disciples were on the lake and Jesus comes walking across the water? That was definitely out of their frame of reference, out of what they understood. And then what about after the resurrection while they're waiting in the upper room? Jesus appears to them. Again, very much out of their frame of reference, thinking out the box. Even if we go into the New Testament, we think about Saul as he travels on the road to Damascus and he goes through that conversion experience, very different from what he understood. Another word that came to mind as I was reflecting on this out of the box experiences is the word wait. Moses had to wait on God to lead the people out of Egypt, wait for his direction and his leading. He had to wait for Pharaoh to reach the point of being willing to let the Israelites go. The disciples had to often wait for Jesus to act. So in the feeding of the 5,000, they come and they give him a few fish and a couple of loaves of bread. They had to wait for Jesus to act. In the upper room, they were waiting for the Holy Spirit to come, the promise of what was to come. Saul had to wait 3 days before Ananias came to heal him of his blindness, but he had to wait. Sometimes waiting for us seems out of the box. We want action, we want resolution, we want solutions, we want remedies, we want answers, and often we want them immediately. We want them now. Waiting is sometimes a little bit of a foreign idea to us. It's out of our box thinking. But maybe part of our spiritual growth is we need to learn to wait. There's a song that is sung by John Waller, which was the theme song to that film a number of years ago called Fireproof. And it's a wonderful, reflective song speaking about while I'm waiting. And so we conclude our time together as I invite you to listen to that song.
It's not easy, no, but faithfully.